Crazy alert!
NHK has learned that the government's nuclear disaster task force did not keep any records of its meetings after the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant accident. NHK has learned that the government's nuclear disaster task force did not keep any records of its meetings after the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant accident.
What the fuck?
The task force made important decisions, including the designation of evacuation areas, basic policies on decontamination, and restrictions on the shipment of agricultural produce.
That's fucked up. Oh, that's fucked up.
The task force, headed by the Prime Minister and including all the cabinet members, was launched on the day of the accident on March 11th last year.
That guy's a creeper. He makes my skin crawl.
NHK asked to see the minutes last November, but only received a list of agenda items for each of the 21 meetings. There were no other records. The person in charge at the Nuclear and Industrial Safety Agency, which acts as the secretariat of the task force, told NHK that he was too busy to write the minutes. The Public Records Management Act requires minutes of important meetings to be kept. This is to ensure that the public can verify the process by which decisions are made.
The records would have been valuable assets to prevent mistakes from being repeated. This is a significant loss for the nation.
The Cabinet Office is interviewing the person in charge at the Nuclear and Industrial Safety Agency. It is also investigating the lack of minutes for meetings of the Joint Task Force of the Tokyo Electric Power Company and the government, which discussed how to deal with the accident.
Hi, Kevin Blanche. I'm going back in the hospital. I want to get this video up before I go back in. Look, I refuse to be a nuclear waste martyr. I refuse. I will not go down like this. I will not go down. You far Neil fucking cod fucking nuclear fucks are wishing me for me to die. You're hoping that I fucking die. Keep wishing, motherfuckers, because if I do fucking die, I'll tell you right now, there's plenty of people out there that got my back that will play these videos over and over and over.
Around 10,000 people will file a class action suit to seek more compensation from Tokyo Electric Power Company. They are residents from an area in the no-entry zone near the stricken Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant. Residents of the Odaka district in Minami Soma City, Fukushima Prefecture, decided to file the suit with the governmental organization set up to mediate disputes with TEPCO for damages. They insist the current payment from the utility is insufficient. On Sunday, about 30 representatives from the district gathered to discuss procedures for filing the claim. The head of the representatives of Odaka, Susumi Yamazawa, said it will be better for the district's residents now living in different locations to claim additional compensation as a group. Roughly 12,000 people from the district are now living as evacuees across Japan. A governmental settlement body was set up last August. It has so far accepted about 660 cases. This will be the first time for a large number of people to file a class action suit with the organization.
I refuse to be a freaking nuclear waste martyr for you fucks.
Japan's foreign minister says the government will invite officials from around the world to an international conference in Fukushima Prefecture later this year to discuss the safety of nuclear plants.
The system is broken!
The event will be jointly hosted by the International Atomic Energy Agency. Koichiro Genba made the announcement on Sunday during a lecture in Fukushima Prefecture. He said at least 50 officials will be invited to the meeting in Kodiyama City in November or December. Genba also said the government will host an international meeting in the prefecture on March 2nd to discuss renewable energy. He added the prefecture wants to develop non-nuclear power generation after the Fukushima disaster. He said it hopes to create jobs by inviting energy-related firms and research institutes.
Look, I had a guy come to my set and he says, you know, why don't you fucks clean up your own backyard before you going off on Japan? Good point. But here's the problem. We're all in the fucking backyard. This is the backyard. Nuclear fallout, don't give a fuck where it's at.
A board of education in northeastern Japan has for the first time admitted responsibility for the deaths of students in last year's tsunami. 70 students of the Okawa Elementary School in Ishinomaki City were killed in the March 11th disaster. Four others remain missing. The education board had briefed parents about the disaster twice before, but its account differed each time. Parents also criticized the board for limiting the number of questions allowed at the meetings. On Sunday, the board held a third meeting with parents. The principal of the elementary school, Teruyuki Kashiba, said the school's anti-disaster measures were inadequate. He said the school had not practiced how to hand students to their parents in the event of a disaster. He also admitted that he did not know the evacuation sites designated in the school disaster manual.
It was a huge natural disaster, but the tsunami hit while the students were in the care of the school, so I can't deny the possibility that human error was partly to blame for their deaths.
It's the first time the education board has admitted responsibility and offered an apology. The board says it will provide further explanations to parents. It also promised to continue searching for the missing students.
Remember, this is where everybody makes their mistake with nuclear fallout. Just because it kills somebody a year later or 5 years or 10, it keeps on killing. It is the murderer that keeps on murdering. It doesn't go away. It is not pollution. It is a cumulative. There are still Finns and Swedes and Danes being born and dying of cancer today from that Tsar bomb. There are fucking millions who die right here on the desert, here in Utah, from the open air fucking tents, across Oklahoma, across Texas, across Idaho, across Washington, across this whole fucking plain, across the old earth. There are people that are dying from the open air tests in Utah, in China. It's called the jet stream. It's called the ocean currents. Now Fukushima is 1,000 times more than all the plutonium that's been released in the history of this world. It's pushed into the greatest food basket in the history of the world.
ちゃんと質問出ないじゃん。本当にこの、リンゴ農家が24日、家族の方が リンゴ畑で固くなっているお父さんを見つけたということでございます。で彼は12月1日に選果場に東電社員のが見えて請求書を受け取っていきました。12月の中ですね、払うということがきちっと分かっていれば、彼はですね、こうならなかったんじゃないかなと。で彼の遺書もあったそうでございます。損害賠償頑張ってくれという一言があったというふうに聞いております。
お亡くなりになったというお話、まあ、私ともちょっと今日初めてその先ほど直前聞かせていただきました。大変残念なことだというふうに思っております。本当にお悔やみ申し上げるとともに、
やはりこのどれほど早くしてもやはり1月になってしまうということで、なんとか1月で私どもとしてはできるように体制を整えていきたいというふうに考えております。
我々何度も交渉やってますよね。で必ずこういう問題っているって言ってましたよね。で本払いできないならばとりあえず仮払いでもいいから請求の半分の上からとりあえず出して、いやー、クレーム迎えられるようにって何度も言ってしまったよね。
また誰か殺したいの？今日来てるよ。12月1日に請求書と立って、12月1日に請求書とこれだけいいんだぞ。おい、誰が自殺出したいのかよ。こんなに来てんだぞ。わかるか？
俺は津波でもねえのか？
ずっと同じこと言ってんだよ。
犠牲者出なかったよ、ちゃんと払ってれば。
そうだ、
福島の社員を信用するな。誰がダメだって言うんだよ。
誰がダメだって言うんだよ。
おっしゃってるのは、その急ぎの仮払いになるのは払うべきというところは、これは私はしっかり聞かせていただいておりますので、そのことをもって社で調整するということでございます。
They want to cut PBS. What did they do? They cut $10 million out of the fucking food inspection chain right as the plutonium is going into the greatest food basket in the world. That's how ignorant, evil, stupid these creepy motherfuckers are. And the media that fucking supports them. Who the fuck are you? Why? Why are you selling your soul to the fucking devil? Why are you selling your fucking soul out to downplay something that is killing people, killing your own people, killing future generations? And you fuckers say clean up your own backyard. I've been trying to clean up. This is the backyard from the open air test in Nevada, who murdered my father, who are trying to murder me, who murder millions every day and don't even know that's who's fucking murdering you. We are all in the backyard of Fukushima, every fucking one of us. That is the point. This doesn't know borders. This doesn't know governments. This doesn't know boundaries. It's called the jet stream. It's called the ocean current. It's called the food chain. You motherfuckers in fucking Fukushima and TEPCO are killing us all. Just like the open air Eugene McCarthy radicals are killing us all. Just like the Sokolov bomb is killing us all. Just like Chernobyl is killing us all. At least Gorbachev entombed it. At least Sokolov come out and warned. At least Oppenheimer come out and warned. What have you fuckers done at Fukushima and the media? Haha, never mind, let's go start another fucking war. Kevin Blanche, I refuse to be fucking go down and die this way. And if you fuckers are rooting for me to die in the far right hairsprayed fucking radical fuck, there's plenty of people that will play my videos over and over and over if I fucking die. Look, and to you alternative medicine guys, I am using a very creative method on this thing. I have not taken radiation treatments. Yes, I've been hammered with chemo hard. Look, I had tumors that were wrapped around my bowel. I was this close to death. I was this close. I was critical for a long fucking time. I had no choice to go the same. But I am using creative treatments. I really am. And I appreciate all you guys' beautiful emails and your support. I love you guys. And I am all about alternative medicines. I am about creative thinking when it comes to everything. Kevin Blanche, stay tuned.